Time for the women's trampoline final here at Tokyo 2019.
The next final, trampoline.
And so the presentation of the athletes in the women's trampoline final. They will, as ever, perform in reverse chronological order from the qualification marks. So we start with Samantha Smith, the eighth strongest in qualification, but she jumped up 9 places from qualifying to semi-final. Yana Lebedieva was the 7th best in the semi-final. She's just 17 years old, jumped 11 places after qualifying. Chisato Doihatsu has already won a team gold medal. She was the 6th best in the semi-final stage. Youth Olympic Games bronze medalist 9 years ago. Léa Labrousse of France is 22. European Games champion, 5th best in qualifying. The defending champion and reigning Olympic champion, Rosie McLennan of Canada, 4th best in the semi-finals. Big mover in the semi-finals, Laura Gallagher of Great Britain went from 13th after qualifying to 3rd. Hikaru Mori of Japan, team gold medalist, 2nd strongest in the semi-finals, the gymnast born in Tokyo. Top qualifier, Huang Yanfei of the People's Republic of China, the 27-year-old. She was a score of 56.82 in the semi-final stage, went up by not far off a whole mark. So we shall see the gymnast perform just a single routine. It's a free routine. And for those of you new to watching trampoline gymnastics, 10 skills. Well, she's had such a connection, Hikaru Mori, with the crowd throughout these World Championships. They've warmed to her so very much indeed. She has an effervescence to her. The women's trampoline final is set to be an absolute thriller. Can Hikaru Mori of Japan displace the top qualifier, Huang Yanfei of the People's Republic of China? And what about the rest of the pack, including reigning world champion, Rosie McLennan?
First finalist representing Canada, Samantha Smith.
Tokyo 2020 will host yet another trampoline gymnastics competition. Made its debut in Sydney. Samantha Smith of Canada, the first to go. She's already taken 2 bronze medals in trampolining in the team and the synchronized events. 8th strongest in qualification, Smith. A big jump up from 17th, or 8th in the semi-finals rather, a big jump up from 17th in qualifying. That's a very tidy, solid start from Samantha Smith. She's very at home in a final. Just recently won the Pan American Games title in Lima, Peru.
Samantha Smith is the current Canadian champion.
So very experienced. She was an alternate gymnast in London for Team Canada. She is so, so determined to get to the Olympic Games.
Tell me that you got me and you're never gonna leave.
The job of the first gymnast, the lowest qualifier, is to get through the routine cleanly and put pressure on the rest. She's done that. 53.45 for Smith.
Yana Limpicheva.
Yana Lebedieva from the Russian Federation, seventh strongest in the semi-final stage, but a big mover. She was 18th in qualification, jumped 11 places. It was a nervy semi-final. She held her nerve, the 17-year-old from St. Petersburg. Can she do it now in the final? This is a bit of a problem. Oh, so the mat has been put into play by the spotter. She was certainly going to make contact with the trampoline bed, but she was likely to fly away at a difficult angle, so the mat was thrown in to rescue her. Let's have another look. Yeah, she's landing on the trampoline bed, but where she goes after that is a safety concern, so they've thrown the mat in as a result. Junior world champion from 2017. Just a teenager. Lot of potential she has. 6.285, she'll be back, no doubt about that. To Chisato Doihata of Japan, having to go slightly earlier than expected due to that shortened routine from Lebedieva. Hi. Team gold medalist Doihata. She's been consistent so far, just 500th difference between her qualifying and semi-final scores. If she matches either of those, she will go into the lead. Graduate of the Nippon Sports Science University here in Tokyo, but she was born in Osaka, in Kansai, across to the west. Those of you new to trampolining, once the gymnast starts, they cannot stop, but they do have license to restart the warm-up bounces if they wish to. They can get time penalties. Away she goes. This is looking secure. Well, there wasn't an awful lot to give away in terms of the horizontal displacement from Chisato Doihata. She is delighted with her display. Very thorough, technically sound work from the 24-year-old. A good case made for a leading score at this stage of the competition. Attending here her fourth World Championships, but it's been her first for 4 years. Picked up her first medal already, the gold in the team event. Let's have another look. Lovely form in the pike with the toe extension, toe point very precise. Kicks out well at the apex of the skill. It's always such technical precision in Japanese trampoline gymnastics. Symmetry, emphatic kick out, toe point is strong again. Lots to like, isn't there? Heels together in the twist position. All the things the judges want to see, certainly what she wanted to see from herself. That's a very fine score from Chisato Doihata, 55.225. Coach says, come on, that was really good. Be louder, and they are. 16.1 execution for Doihata. She's in the gold medal position.
Léa
Labrousse of France, the fifth strongest in the semi-final stage, jumped up three places from the qualification process. 54.96 is the best score of her process so far. Well, She did well to control some potentially tricky moments, LaBruce, the European Games champion from Minsk earlier this year in the summer. Second time she's made an individual final. She was fourth in 2017, sixth in 2018. Get some nice fluid rotations in, really wraps the knees in towards the chest when she tucks her body. Nice little kick out position. Good detail to her work as LaBruce. Doihatta leads, then Smith, then Lebedieva, but Lebedieva will drop out of medal contention when this score comes in. LaBruce goes into the silver medal position with a 54.42 score. The most difficult routine that we've seen so far.
Next, representing Canada, Rosanna McLennan.
Canada's Rosie McLennan. Here we have the opportunity to look at one of the very greatest ever to do this. The reigning Olympic and world champion. She was 10th after the qualification process, jumped up to 4th in the semi-finals. And she is a winner when she gets into finals. Such an occasion handler. 31-year-old. Very well controlled routine from Rosie McLennan. She's wondering, is it going to be enough? The experience left and right there of your picture. So much experience between them. Won her first world championship for 5 years last year. It's her third individual title. It was back in 2007. When she won the first. The nice and the knees, this is what the judges are looking for. 55.225, the leading mark, Chisato Doihatta. McLennan hits 54.82. She's in the silver medal position still. Doihatta leads. 0.4 more difficult than Doihatta, but the execution 0.4 down. Laura Gallagher of Great Britain. Now this will be interesting because Gallagher scored a 54.3 in qualification, 13th best. She went up by a mark for the semi-finals to be the third strongest performer. She posted, of everyone, the biggest improvement in score between qualifying and semi-final. Already a team silver medalist from earlier on in the World Championships. Another occasion well handled by Great Britain's Laura Gallagher. It's going to go down to the wire, this competition. How wonderful that Laura Gallagher has persevered with her career when she had to take some time out a few years ago with injury difficulties. She is a tenacious competitor.
She won the team bronze medal. 2017 Sofia.
Some good difficulty in the routine. She was a little bit clear in some of the horizontal displacement. There were other parts of the routine that were very located in the centre. They were happy, the British team. So how close does she get to that leading position? 54.09 for Gallagher down in fourth place. Execution score 15.4. It's Doihata still with the strongest execution. 16.1, the only 16 plus score. Doihata, as a result, has just secured a medal. So Chisato Doihata will at least take bronze. What about Hikaru Mori? Gold medal in the team event. Synchronized gold medal last year with Mago Ueyama. The first Japanese woman to win World Championship gold. She was the second strongest in the semi-finals, gained just over half a mark from her qualification display. They want it so desperately, the Japanese crowd. They are so hopeful. She's been so talked about in the media in the last few days. You know, if Hikaru Mori feels pressure, you wouldn't really know it, would you? You would not know it. Much more muted on that occasion in her reaction. They are beaming in the crowd. But Hikaru Mori is getting very used to coming into big competitions and delivering quality routines. There is fluidity in her work, a little bit of leg bend. Good symmetrical tuck. Kick out was very sharp. Toe point is exact there in the twist as well. Now such an anxious wait for Hikaru Mori. Doihata leads the way. Mori leads the way. Now the reaction, now the noise, now the emotion. Will it be the gold? 55.86, Hikaru Mori is in pole position once again. Chisato Doihata into silver, into second place with one to go.
Next, representing the People's Republic of China.
She had that stored up, that reaction, didn't she? Now to Huang Yanfei of the People's Republic of China, the 27-year-old from Guangdong, the strongest performer in the semi-final stage. She gained over three quarters of a mark from qualification. The crowd is hushed and respectful. She's a little bit out of position. Well restored. Kept her nerve, very much kept her nerve, Huang Yanfei. There was quite a bit of horizontal movement. How will that compare? Hikaru Mori's horizontal displacement score 9.5. Joint second best that we've seen so far. Wang Yanfei may find that hers is a little bit lower. Let's have a look back at the moments of the routine. Very secure pike work. Tucks in tightly. Again, sharp in the kick out like we've seen from so many. He's got some good difficulty. A little bit of leg bend. Not on that occasion. Really sharp when she twists. Gets a nice straight body position. So Hikaru Mori, then Chisato Doihata, then Rosie McLennan. Wang Yanfei, the last gymnast to have her score come in. She's in fourth position, 54.705. And you know what that means, don't you? It means that Hikaru Mori is the world champion. The 20-year-old in the city in which she was born wins the world title in the arena that's going to host the Olympic Games in a matter of months. Chisato Doihata, the silver medalist. It is Hikaru Mori, exuberant as ever, who has taken the World Championship title. Some stories seem to write themselves. Some stories seem too good to be true. But if you dare to dream, then dreams do become reality. Hikaru Mori has worked like mad for this moment. It's not been all smiles and laughter along the way. It's been hard graft in the gym. She moved away from Tokyo to Kanazawa when she was 16. Found it a tough experience, was lonely. Stayed with it, kept going, had invaluable family support, and now she stands there, back in her home city as the world champion. And joined by a wonderful gymnast in Chisato Doihata. The bronze medal to Rosie McLennan of Canada, the silver to Chisato Doihata of Japan, and the gold medal to Hikaru Mori of the host nation. Let's also just take a moment to reflect upon Rosie McLennan. There's a great story here. Her grandfather was selected as a gymnast for the Olympic Games that were due to take place in Tokyo in 1940. Obviously, for complex reasons, they were not able to take place. But Rosie McLennan in this city takes the bronze medal and has dreams of further success in Tokyo at the Olympic Games. Chisato Doihata of Japan, the silver medalist. What a wonderful return to the World Championships for her it has been. First since 2015, and she comes away with a gold and a silver. Welcome back to the national team for her. They expected, they dreamed, and they woke up and found that dreams and reality were one and the same. Hikaru Mori, the world champion.
Rosanna McLennan!
Sometimes an athlete just inhabits an occasion. Sometimes a sense of destiny seems to unfold. And it has done here for Hikaru Mori. For the first time, a Japanese woman is the individual world champion And guess where they've done it? In Tokyo, with the Olympics just around the corner.
Yuzuru Nippon Morning Magazine!